All right, so I'm making this video not as so much a response to Nightmare Fuel, but there will be a response to it in this video, but mostly as my kind of flag in the ground against anti-theism as an atheist. But first, let me express my disdain for people who try to use umbrella terms that describe a vast array of different organizations and individuals who have varying different beliefs, but usually a set of very common beliefs, i.e. like terms like Christianity or Islam or Hindu. Again, like these internally, people who call themselves Christians have vast different beliefs from each other and disagree with each other on a lot of different things, which is not typically a hallmark of what we would associate being a cult. Either way, but when people say that Christianity is a cult or Islam is a cult or Hinduism is a cult, it's fucking stupid, because when you say that these people are members of a cult, the implication is very clear that you're talking about a cult like Jonestown or a cult like Scientology or the Moonies, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, or Amway, where people are like being abused or lied to or defrauded, and it's a high demand group. That's what we understand the cult to be. Otherwise, you would have issued a qualifier. Oh, well, not like Jonestown, but you know, but kind of culty. Or you would have said something like a benign cult, etc. But you didn't. So you're trying to make the implication that these groups are similar, that all Christians are basically members of Jonestown, which they're not. Clearly not. No, any cult expert will tell you, in any criteria that would make up a cult, people who deal with people who are recovering from cult abuse will all tell you that there are a set of criteria. And before you can even go into the criteria of what makes a group a cult, is that the first one is that it has to be an abusive group or an abusive organization, which would be a better term for a group. What's what they're talking about? Because a high demand group can't be just a broad umbrella term for a group of ideals, because they are not a group. There is no one leading. There's no organization that is in control of Christianity. Now I know, and I've made this point before, and I've had idiots make this claim to me, so I'm going to clarify it for the single digit IQ people out there. The Vatican does not control Christianity. If you don't believe me, go to any Baptist church and tell them that the Pope is their leader, and you will get an earful. So anyways, yeah, that fucking pisses me off when I hear anti-theists make this claim. But Nightmare Fuel made this video, just for the response portion of this video, I guess, made this video where he's going after certain people making claims about anti-theism. You know, anti-theism is wrong. And one of them was an internet buddy of mine, Voltaire, who is a Christian, who made a claim on Twitter saying his problem with anti-theism is that it could possibly lead to bigotry. And Nightmare's responses, and I'm not kidding here, it was asinine, was, well, there's lots of bigots and sexist people in Christianity who use biblical justifications for these things, and people will inevitably do so in the future. Ergo, anti-theism can't be that way, or isn't that way, or is okay if the bigotry to go on inside of anti-theism is okay. I'm not exactly sure what the point of bringing up a tout croquet out of this thing is, but that's pretty much what his point was, which on its face is not valid. It's not a valid case to make. Yes, it's very well possible that anti-theism can lead to bigotry, as exampled in his own video trying to dispel this rumor, where he's referring to Voltaire as a cult member because he's a Christian, which, as far as I'm aware, he's not a member of any of the Christian-based high-demand groups that I'm aware of. But, you know, he seems to know. So apparently he knows that he's a member of, I don't know, fucking Jonestown, I guess. But This is what pisses me off about movement atheists and anti-theism, is that they genuinely believe that, like, if religion goes away, that all forms of bigotry would end, that terrorism would pretty much, or at least for the most part, that bigotry would end and terrorism will end and wars will end and we wouldn't have to deal with any of the problems with government. Everything would just be fine because we don't have these religious zealots at the helms anymore. And I kind of want to dispel that stuff with a few examples. So I was an anti-theist for about a year or two, and then I quickly woke up to realize that, no, atheists can be just as stupid and just as retarded as anyone else, and that anti-theism itself is a religious belief that believes in things that are just as absurd as people walking on water or dying and coming back to life in 3 days or any other virgin births or... you know, gods with endless wives having celestial sex on Kolob, like any crazy religious belief that you want to dig up, theirs is just as stupid. And mainly is that if we get rid of religion, terrorism and war and governments would all just be working to a lesser or greater degree, nearly perfect or good, or at least good. Which I'm going to give you some examples that that's not particularly the case. So I made this Twitter tweet storm, and I'm going to basically read it to you, and then I'm going to add commentary when I feel necessary. So if you want to read the whole thing without my interruptions, go ahead. I'm not going to tell you when I'm interjecting. So anti-theism is every bit as religious as Christianity. It has bizarre beliefs, revered saints who are morally despicable, and it has a higher cause that doesn't reel. So again, yes, they do have bizarre beliefs. I went over some of these. I'm going to go over them some. I'm going to go into this into some deep detail about these in a second. There's a lot of revered saints that were just not allowed to question at all, nearly at all. Anytime someone does question these, and I've experienced this too, is anytime I question some of the things that Dawkins says, like when Dawkins says that whether the existence of God is a scientific approach and not a philosophical approach, I disagree with that. And if you were to mention that you have any kind of disagreement with Dawkins, you'd get some pretty rabid responses from people accusing you of being a Christian. And their proof is basically like Jesus is in my internet username. okay. I don't know too many Christians that would call themselves Jesus, but that's besides the point. You're not allowed to, you know, question them or anything like that. There are just as revered saints as, you know, Mother Teresa, who have a lot of these people, and I'm not going to name names. A lot of these people have some pretty nasty personal failings of their own, which is not relevant. I'm more interested in their ideas, and some of their ideas are good. Some of their ideas are bad, but that's fine. And some of their moral failings are really bad. But again, a lot of these people will not allow you to question it, especially anti-theists. Normal atheists usually will say like, well, yeah, you know, this person may have done something terrible, or this person has said some pretty crazy off the wall things that I completely disagree with, but what he says about atheism is pretty spot on. I can agree with that. And yeah, they do have a higher cause that does not reel. That is to go around and try to fix everybody's religiosity because it'll improve the world. And, you know, and people are willing to die for that cause in some cases. That's pretty fucking spooky, dude. All right, so going on. Bizarre beliefs. These are some of the bizarre beliefs that anti-theists hold. The world would be a better place without religion. No, people will just find a secular reason to be shitty, violent, and tyrannical. History has showed this again and again. All right. A lot of very despotic regimes, I would probably say the majority of them in recent times, have been secular. The USSR, the People's Republic of China, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, arguably Nazi Germany. A lot of these despotic regimes have been fairly secular, i.e. they have not been religious, or at least religious of pre-existing religions like Christianity, Hinduism, etc. In fact, most of the ones that are founded on any kind of Christian ideals, not always, there have been some that are terrible for sure. I'm not saying that's necessarily true. But it seems as though there is a lot more quote unquote secular atheist tyrannical states than there have been to the contrary. Right. And that's not an advocation of having a religious government. It's just showing you that just because someone knows that God doesn't real, ergo good. No, it's just not the case. There's been very genocidal, maniac people at the helm who were avowed atheists. Going on. So there would be less wars. No, most wars are fought over resources. They use religious reasons to justify it. To get rid of those religious reasons, and they will seek other just as stupid secular justifications for those war. So there's a lot of wars that people assume are religious in nature, i.e. Al-Qaeda's war on the West is a jihad. While this is true, they advocate that, yes, they're doing this for religious ideals. A lot of this stuff has to do with resources and land. Mostly with Israel's occupation of various land within that region. Or the U.S. intervention in the Middle East in various wars. Now, there are some religious justifications for this, for sure. But if you were to get rid of those religious justifications, they would find more secular bullshit things to fight over. That's just the way it is. All right. People have violent tendencies, and they use various justifications for why they want to execute on these violent behaviors. And if religion makes them look good in the eye of the public or will help get support for their cause, then they're going to use it. If it doesn't, they're going to find something else. And people have fought wars over ideologies, secular ideologies as well, right? Very much so, especially in the USSR. A lot of their expansionist wars have been very atheistic. Let's see, there would be less sexism and bigotry. No, even in secular states, there's been racism, sexism, homophobia, et cetera, et cetera. Again, there's no correlation, and people just... There's no correlation. Again, people just stop using religious reasons and find more secular ones. There's a lot of hate groups in the United States and elsewhere around the world that are explicitly secular in nature, who have anti-Semitic, racist, homophobic, transphobic, blah, 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 phobic, blah, 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 phobic, et cetera, et cetera, whatever kind of phobic you want to throw at it, racist, whatever, tendencies. There's a lot of people on YouTube who are members of the alternative right, who we keep getting told is literally Satan by a lot of these anti-theists, who are atheists. And I can name them by name. If you want me to name them by name, all right. Christopher Cantwell, atheist. Marocchio, atheist. Fringe Elements, last I check, or what is he now? Whatever name he is, Ryan Falk, atheist. A lot of these people have been atheists. All right. Atheism doesn't make you automatically nice. It just makes you probably right about one thing. So it's going on. It would make the world more rational. Oh, God, no. If you want to know rationality, go to some of these atheist meetups, especially people on the kind of SJW side. It would make people probably right about one thing and nothing more. They will still buy into things like astrology, anti-GMO stuff, conspiracy theories, quack medicine, secular spiritualism, dangerous ideologies. All right? Like, how many atheists do I know who still believe in astrology? I mean, I can't even count how many times I've ran into quote on people who are like enlightened or whatever, because they know God doesn't real anymore, but they still think that, you know, Monsanto is putting poison in the food. It's insane. Or believe that 9/11 was an inside job. You know? All right. That it would reduce terrorism. No, again, people would find secular reasons to be violent and shitty, blah, 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 blah. I keep saying this over and over again, but it seems as though like this is not resonating at all. There are secular terrorist groups that have been very, very, very successful, that have non-religious reasons for carrying out their terror. Environmentalism, socialism, Marxism, animal rights, racist groups, far right groups, you name them. They have had terrorist factions of those ideologies, right? If you get rid of Jeebus, people are just going to find something else to get violent about. That has always been the case. Always, 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 always. Another one. This one's kind of rare, but it comes up every once in a while, is that abusive cults will go away. So we were talking about abusive cults earlier. Abusive cults will go away. No. Way the fuck no. Most of the abusive cults, a.k.a. high-demand groups, are secular. MLMs, atheist, which stands for multi-level marketing schemes, financial cults, etc. Atheistic religious cults, self-help cults, meditation cults, political cults make up more on the list of, you know, identified high demand groups than explicitly theistic ones by far. And in fact, the largest cult in the world in recorded history is the People's Republic of China. The People's Republic of China is by far the biggest cult that has ever existed. It consists of billions of people, the likes of which have never been seen in human history. And they follow, in fact, the original criteria used by cult experts have been Lifton's 8 criteria for thought reform groups, was developed based on brainwashing techniques or thought reform techniques that were developed in China. And in case you forgot, the People's Republic of China and Korea too, I guess, have been explicitly atheist. So you stop believing in God. Cool. You're not any better for it. You're just probably right about one thing and wrong about everything else as you were before. So, and then I also said, and please, for the love of God, please stop calling Christianity or Islam a cult. A cult has to be a unified organization before we can even compare it against a criteria for a thought reform group. Most Christians disagree on a lot of things. Same with Muslims. Not exactly a hallmark of a cult. So that's why I don't identify with movement atheism or anti-theism or whatever. It's just it's a bunch of silly religious beliefs that don't make any fucking sense, and you might as well believe that Xenu, is infecting you with body thetans than to believe that, you know, once people stop, you know, once people realize that God doesn't real, that, you know, magic things will happen. It's fucking retarded. Anyways, I'll talk to you guys later. Hail Satan. Oh, by the way, man with the penis, you should listen to the last episode of The Lawbirds. I think you'd like that one. Hail Satan.